Let's summarize the three methods we used for graphing lines. First, plotting points by making a table of ordered pairs. This method always works, but it can be time consuming. This is where you plug in a number for x, anything you want, and solve for y. That gives you one ordered pair, and you do that for three or four ordered pairs. The second method we did was by using the intercept method. We found the x-intercept and the y-intercept, and this won't work if it goes to the origin, because that way you only have one point, the origin. So you need to have a separate x and y-intercept. And the third method was the slope-intercept method, where we put it in the form y equals mx plus b, and this works unless the line's a vertical line, which means it's in the form x equals k, which means you can't solve for y and put it in that method, in that form. So what I want to go over is which method are we going to use for a particular problem. So let's say we had this, y equals 3x minus 1. Which method would you use? Well, I would either use plotting points, because it's pretty simple. You could just make a chart, because it's solved for y, or use the slope-intercept method. If I use the slope-intercept method, I would say the slope is 3 and the y-intercept is negative 1. Since it's solved for y, either of these methods is easy to use. So let's say I wanted to do it by making a table. I pick any number you want for x, so how about I pick 0, 1, and 2. And remember, you put in 0 for x, and then y would be negative 1. If you put in 1 for x, let's see, that would be 3 times 1. 3 minus 1 is 2. And then I could put in 2 for x. 6 minus 1 is 5. And we'd have three ordered pairs. If we did it by the slope-intercept method, I would write the slope as a fraction, and you have this ordered pair 0, negative 1. No matter which method I use, I'm going to be able to graph the line. So I want you to put this on pause, graph the line using either of these methods, or both of the methods, and see if you get the same thing I would get. All right, I'm making a crude graph here, just to get the idea. So, if I use plotting points, I would do 0, negative 1, 1, 2, and 2, 5. See, I'd have to go all the way up to here. Oops, I didn't do 1, 2. I did 1, 1. We want to do 1, 2, which is up here, and 2, 5, which is about here. All right, I have those three points. Now, what if I did the slope-intercept method? I would start out at 0, negative 1, and I use the slope over 1 and up 3. Check it out, I get the same point. Over 1, up 3, same point, and there you go. So if the equation is solved for y, it's usually easier to use either of these methods, whichever you're more comfortable with. Now, here's an equation where it's not solved for y. When it's not solved for y, and you've got both the x term and the y term on the left-hand side, I usually use the x and y intercept method. So let's do the x and y intercept method here. For the x intercept, remember we're going to put in 0 for y into the equation. And for the y intercept, we're going to put in 0 for x into the equation. All right, so if we look at the equation up here, 2x plus 5y is 10, and put in 0 for y, you've got 2x is 10, so x is 5. So that's 5, 0. And then let's go back to the original equation, put in 0 for x, that gives me 5y is 10, so y is 2. So now I've got two ordered pairs, 5, 0, and 0, 2. So we plot those. And carefully graph the line. Okay, I know mine isn't very exact here. It looks like it's going through 4 and a half. Pretend it's going through 5, 0 here. Now, one other thing you can do is solve for y and put it in slope-intercept form and see if it matches. Like, does it look like the slope is, correct? So if I did that, I would take the equation, That was 2x plus 5y is 10. 2x plus 5y is 10. If you wanted to know the slope, you could solve for y. And see that your slope is negative 2/5, and it does look like it's slanting the right direction here. And 10 over 5, that's your y-intercept. So if you were to solve for y, you could see that you would get the same line. Remember, you could also get the slope by using the formula for slope. Since you know the x and y-intercepts, you could use the formula for slope with 5, 0, and 0, 2. You know, the difference of the y's over the difference of the x's. As a little reminder, you put one ordered pair, y over x, 0 over 5. The other ordered pair, y over x, 2 over 0. And if you simplify that, you are going to get negative 2/5. Right? You're going to get negative 2/5. So that is the equation of the line using the x and y intercept method is how I did it originally. Right? I did the x and y intercept method. But if you wanted to solve for y and use the slope intercept method, you would have gotten that the y intercept was 2, and then you would have used the slope of, what did we say the slope was? It was negative 2/5. How about negative 2 over positive 5 by going over 5 and down 2 and gotten that point as well. So multiple ways to do it. My suggestion is if it's in the form ax plus by equals c, in other words, both the x term and the y term are on the left-hand side, to go ahead and use the x and y intercepts. Here's one more problem where we've got it in the form of where it's not solved for y. So I would usually do the x and y intercepts here, except you will get a fraction for the x-intercept. But let's go ahead and do it anyway. The x-intercept, you're going to put in 0 for y, so that gives you 4x is 15, 15/4. Well, you'll kind of want to write that as a mixed number to graph it. So that's 3 and 3/4, so it's almost to 4. And the y-intercept, you're going to put in 0 for x. That's a little bit nicer. We get negative 5y equals 15, so y is negative 3. So you could go ahead and plot these, but sometimes that's hard on graph paper to get it exact. So if you get fractions for your x or y intercept, sometimes it's easier to do the slope-intercept method. So if I take this equation and I solve for y, I have to subtract 4x from both sides and then divide by negative 5. So I get the slope of 4/5 here when I write it in slope-intercept form, y equals 4/5 x minus 3, it's a little bit easier to plot the points. And you can get them without putting any fractions on your graphs. So let's see. Let's do it both ways. We've got, let me write these different points out. We've got 3 and 3, 4, 0, and 0, negative 3 using the slope-intercept method. And if I did it in slope-intercept form, I had y equals 4/5 x minus 3. So what happens here if I try to graph it? All right, so we've got x and y. All right, let's do it using the slope-intercept method so that I don't have to worry about graphing fractions. I've got the y-intercept is negative 3, so it's down here. And now the slope is 4/5, so I'm going to go, oh, I put that was 5, but I meant to write that this was the number 4. All right, so I need to go over 5, and then up 4, and I have a point right here. All right. So if you're on a computer and you can't draw anything except through integer x and y points, then you would have to do something like this. And I've got it. All Right, now, does that match up with what I have for my x and y intercepts here? I've got 3 and 3 fourths 0. Yes, that looks about 3 and 3 fourths 0. And I've got 0, negative 3. And so there's your line. So you can do it either way. But if you're constricted by where you can plot points, if they have to go through integers for the x or y coordinates, then putting it in slope-intercept form might help you with that. So in summary, if it's already solved for y, I would use the slope-intercept method or making a table of ordered pairs. And if it has ax plus by equals c, it's usually easier to use the x and y intercepts.